Hey everyone, this is the next video in our series about service registry and discovery. In the previous video, I have explained you why do we need this in our microservices architecture. We have covered the theory part. We have also covered the demo part, how to create the Eureka server and how to register the individual microservices with that Eureka server and how to use that Eureka server in our client to discover the individual microservices and call that. This is the part 2 of that one where we were discovering the services, and we will explore more about the Eureka discovery client and what it can do, right? So this is the design that we have seen in the demo. These are the doctor services, patient service, digital service, and this is the Eureka server. These all have registered themselves with the Eureka server, right? And now doctor portal is using the service ID and querying the Eureka server to get the individual service to call that, right? So we have one instance, two instances of this, and one instance of this, and one instance, two instances of this, right? So we have seen when you are adding the instances, it is getting registered with the Eureka server properly. In this video, I am going to explain you if you shut down an instance, how it can communicate that to Eureka server. First of all, when you are adding new instance, how Eureka server gets to know that there is new instance available. So in individual services, you get the address of this one, right? And after that, Eureka server and this individual service is checking the health status, whatever instance is with that, with the heartbeat, right? There is a concept of heartbeat, where it is checking the health of each service that it has, Eureka server has registered with it, right? So that heartbeat, so by default 30 seconds, it has time of 30 seconds, right? In each 30 seconds, Eureka server sends the heartbeat to check if individual service that was registered with it is available or not. If it is not available, it keeps sending the heartbeat. So it tries to send it three times, right? And after three times, if it is not getting the proper response from that service, it marks that service as down, right? So one service, if it is down, it can be down for 90 seconds, but still on the Eureka server, it will show as available, right? So this is the by default behavior. So it has to be taken care when you are designing this thing, right? When your service is down, it has to properly communicate to Eureka server. But this is the default behavior that you, so in many cases, it may be the cases that you have shut down your service and it has not properly shut down and it was not able to communicate to Eureka server. So it will show in the Eureka server that it is up, but actually it is down. Okay. So this is the compromise with the distributed system, right? So you have to take care of this situation properly. So go ahead and see the Eureka server. Go ahead further and see when you are setting down one instance, how it is behaving in the demo, right? So this is the first part of the video where I have explained you how to connect and all those stuffs, right? So these are the things that you can review that one if you have not watched that. This is the Eureka server running. These all are the instances right here registered with this Eureka server. This is a disease service, doctor service, and the patient service, one instance of this one, right? And I can call, our doctor portal is running on port 7081. If I go doctor portal, it is running on port 7081, right? And we have endpoints, patient, disease, and then through that we are communicating with this one. You want to understand these, watch the previous video, right? So the purpose of this video, when an individual instance is down, how it is going to communicate, right? So if I refresh this one, doctor service, so I'll be able to see the 9082 9081 properly, right? And it is registered with here, right? So this is the doctor service. So what I am going to do, I am going to stop one instance of doctor service, right? So let's see how it is behaving in that case, right? So go to doctor portal is here and doctor service is here, and come to terminal. It is running here on port. The response status this, and it is running on some port 809082. So this is kind of command line the terminal. So I am pressing the control C, right? So control C, when you press the control C, it is properly shutting down, right? So you see, when you press the control C, it is unregistering properly, shutting down discovery client and all those information that you see. Come to the Eureka client. If I refresh this portal, so yeah, I can see that instance got down from here. And if I further hit doctors, so I'll be seeing the instance that is running on 9081 only, right? So because shutdown was proper, the cleanup part, it communicated properly. If I see the logs here, right? If I see the logs on this doctor service, so local status change, discovery client, shutting down executor application, shutting down discovery client, it is unregistering, sending the request to unregister, right? So deregister status is 200. So deregistering with the Eureka server was successful, right? So that is why it happened properly. It is not even waiting for the 30 second that heartbeat part, because it is automatically sending that I am going down, you take that, take this request, right? So if I go to Eureka discovery server demo, on the logs you can see, okay, cancel localhost failed with the response code 404, right? So it is not deregister request replication false with 9082 with the status down, right? So status down request was taken properly here, right? So let me clear the logs. And then what I'm now, we have one other demo. So we have digit service now, which has two instances. So let me go ahead and stop one instance of this one abruptly, not with the control C, where it will be sending the proper request, right? So which one is this? This is the digit service, right? So digit service, go to digit service, and it one is running on the command line. So let that running. So stop this from here, right? So it will not be, when I stop this, it is the abrupt shutdown, right? So it will not be able to send the request properly to deregister and all that. So I stop this, it finished the process. And if I go here on Eureka, right, it is still showing that it is up, right? But if I come here on this disease part, so 8082 is coming properly, and next it is trying to hit the port 8081, right? So it is trying to connect to 8081, but it is not available because that is down. If I explain with this diagram, this doctor portal is queried about the patient digit service. So it is saying that there are two instances running, but actually one instance is down at this moment, right? But it has not information about that. So that is why it is trying to hit that one. But we are getting the exception because that doesn't exist physically now, right? So if I refresh this, if that 90 second passed, right, so it will know at that moment that actually that service is down, right? So we will be able to see the 8082 only. So still it has information that 8081 is there because 90 second is not passed yet, right? So when that 90 second is passed, it will deregister that automatically, right? Running the evict task compensation, and this is doing all these stuffs. So you have to wait till that time, and then it will be deregistered automatically. Eureka server demo, and come here on Eureka, refresh this. Sometimes it can take time, okay. Let it complete, and in the meantime, let me explain you one more thing that is there. So sometimes And this is the dzone page evicting instances from Eureka that I was facing issue, and then searched on internet and I got the solution here, right? So sometimes when you start your Eureka server, you will get this notification. At the start of the video, when I was starting it, I got this one, right? So emergency Eureka may be incorrectly claiming instances are up when they are not. The same situation that we are facing right now, right? So this is a thing, and this is the reason why do we get that. So you can go through this article and see this why it is. So it is something called self-preservation mode, and if you want to avoid this message, you can make this property in your configuration file, and then it will not show off in your Eureka server if it is showing, right? So come to Eureka discovery server running the eviction. Yeah, now it got the information about that DG service that the other instance is down, right? So we are able to see this one. So if I refresh this one, when first querying, it is taking some time. Okay. So it got the response from 802. If I refresh this, only 8082 respond will respond, because now it knows that 8081 is gone down, right? So this is the information that, so renew, how many instances renew has happened, that information is coming here, right? So this was kind of a starting point for the Eureka servers, right? And you have now understanding proper what it is and how you can use it in your company if you're working. So you can suggest this one. This is pretty much important. Okay. So when experimenting and seeing around, if you see any issue, want to understand more about it, you just put that in comment section. I'll be happy to help you out. So we can discuss more about it, Eureka advanced concept about it, right? So from my side, this topic is has come to end. Okay, so still if I see anything new, I'll try to make one or two more video about it, and in the meantime I am going to start a new topic which will be about distributed tracing. The next topic is distributed tracing. So distributed tracing, maybe if you are in microservices architecture, if you're using that, so maybe you have heard of Sleuth and Zipkin. So these are the libraries that provide this one, right? So this is the very good concept and help a lot in debugging your application. So this is in my mind, so that I'll be making the video on. So I also have request to make the videos on Spring Security, right? So or build.gradle tutorial, right? So I'll be making the videos on these two topics also, but these are the core concept for the microservices. So first I want to cover this also. In the meantime, you can also suggest me the more topics that I can cover, right? So I'll try to cover that also, right? So let's learn together and share the knowledge that you have and I have. Okay, so I hope you are learning from this video, these videos that I am uploading. So your feedback is pretty much important for me to improve on. So I hope you will be suggesting me the new topics, improvements, and all those stuff in the comment section. So this is the expectation from you guys. Okay, so you play around with all of this, and I'll see you in the next video with this topic, distributed tracing, right? So